Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I am doing this look.
What the fuck?
Okay. What the fuck? So it's just kind of like a nudie cut crease. So I do apologize for the lighting for the rest of the video. I forgot my light. I left it in Ballarat at my parents' place. So I'm just relying on natural lighting. So sorry if it looks a little bit like shit. I can't really help that, but hopefully it's, you know, the sun's got my back today. So hopefully it turns out all right. Why the fuck is that so bitchy, man? If you're wondering how I got this look today, just keep on watching, baby, keep on watching. So what I want to start off first with is just to moisturize and prime my face. So I'm just going to add some eye cream as well as some moisturizer. So for my brows today, I'm using Kapow by Benefit in the color 3. And I'm using the Zoeva 317 winged eyeliner brush for my brows, just because I find it's more angled compared to the 322 brow line. I just found it's easier to use for me. And just fill that in. So I got my eyebrows actually on the weekend, so they're not too fucking disgusting. Next, to clean my brows up, I'm going to be using the MAC Studio Finish Concealer in the shade A96. It, and I'll be taking this random brush that I got off Wish just to apply that, because it is quite thick. I'll be taking the exact same concealer and popping that all over my eyelid for my base of my eyeshadow. And I'm just going to use my beauty blender to blend that out. So for my base of my eyes, I'm going to be taking, what the fuck? It's like all this phlegm in my throat for some reason. So I'm going to be taking the Tartlet, if that's what it's called, palette. And I'm going to be using the shade Flower Child just as like a... So next I'm going to be taking from the Modern Renaissance palette, the shade Raw Sienna, just as a transition colour above my crease. So I'll be taking my Morphe 35P palette. It is rather old, that is why it's a bit rank, so just like, don't judge please. I'm going to be taking this shade here and I'll be using to apply it with the 227 Zoeva Soft Definer in the Vegan range. And I'm just going to pop that. Ooh, my nose! Within my crease. So. Next, I'll be taking this shade here and adding it even more into my crease, I guess, just to really darken it up a little bit more. I forgot to mention, so the brush that I'm using, all my brushes are either Zoeva or they are just random brushes that I have collected throughout my life, or some Real Techniques, so just saying, okay? So if you hear a lot of Zoeva, that's why, because I fucking love it and they're good brushes. Anyway, so the brush that I'm using is the 227 Glick Soft Definer. I actually really like this. It does shed a tiny bit, but not as bad as some other brushes. So just letting y'all know before you come for me. Before you come for me. Alright, so now that that's all blended, I'm going to take my MAC concealer again and we're going to do a cut crease, bitch. Alright, so I just slowly outline where I'm going to go. So it looks like this. Okay. Sorry, fucking, when you say ugly, right? Focus on ya. So it looks like this. Next, I will take the Anastasia Beverly Hills Nicole Grillo. I can't even pronounce her last name. And the highlighting palette. It looks like this because I dropped it and my friend helped me put it back together with rubbing alcohol. So if that ever happens to you, just put a little bit of rubbing alcohol and just like set it, and then it'll leave it to dry and it'll just go back to normal. So that's why it's a bit fucked. So yeah, that was really the saddest moment of my life. So I'm gonna take the shade Forever Young, and with my random nude packing brush, I'm just gonna apply it where I applied my concealer. So I just added some glue to my eyelashes and now I'm waiting for them to become tacky. I'm just going to take this orange colour here from my Kryolan Dermacolor Flush Cream Kit. So I'm just going to pop this under my eyes just because I do feel really, quite literally feel like shit. So I'm just going to try to get rid of some of the purpleness under my eyes just to help brighten it a little bit more. That's like fucking it. And then I'm just gonna take my beauty blender and blend that out. Ta-da! Or as what they say in Canada, oots. There you go. Okay. So, now that that's blended and I look like a fucking orange piece of shit, I'm going to apply my eyelashes. So the eyelashes I'm using are the Huda Beauty the Sophia Mink Collection. Blink. And I'm just gonna apply that. So this is actually my mom's jumper and it's so warm and it's so fucking fluffy. I just like, oh, it's so soft. Next, the fuck up. It's my foundation. So today I'll be taking the Cover FX Natural Finish Oil Free Foundation in the shade G+50. Smear that. Oh yeah, baby. Everywhere. I might put a little bit too much, but I'm gonna fuck. Next, I'll be taking my Zoeva 104 Buffer Brush. And just a buff that out clearly. And then I'm going to take my beauty blender and just run it all over my face just to get rid of any streak line at all, just because this is a thicker foundation. I need to get up in between my nose because my brush is too big. Okay, now that I've blended that all out, I'm going to give my face a quick spritz with my MAC Fix Plus. Just to add a little bit more hydration. I'm gonna be taking my good old NARS Creamy Concealer. Apply that all over under my eyes and on my cheekbones. I'm just gonna use my beauty blender and blend it out. So I'm gonna be taking my good old Anastasia Beverly Hills cream contour palette and the second shade here for my contour. And another spritz of my MAC Fix Plus. Now I'm just gonna blend that out with my beauty blender. And then I'm going to take my NARS Cream Concealer and just run it underneath where I just contoured. Just to clean it up a little bit. Okay, so now that that's all blended out, okay, I'm going to be taking my Dermacolor Camouflage, what the fuck? Dermacolor Fixing Powder. I'm just gonna bake under my eyes. But what I found, if I really, really pack it in, I don't actually have to have it sitting there just as long, so I can do other shit. You really just pack it in. Next, I'm going to bronze my face with the Hoola Bronzer by Benefit, and I'm going to take this really fat fan brush. I actually got this in Bali and it's really good. Some of the bristles are a little bit funky, but it hasn't shed, so I'm pretty happy with that. Just to give me more of a light bronze than something that would be really, really harsh. I'm going to take my Zoeva 106 powder brush and just blend that away. And this just helps soften my contour line as well, so it's not so like, do you know what I mean? Like, it just helps buff out a little bit more of that powder. Using the Huda Beauty 3D palette, and I'll be using the shade Ibiza. This is like a little bit of a highlighter, a little bit of a blush at the same time, so you can kind of see there. So it just adds a little bit of color to my face, as well as a little bit of highlight. And then for my highlight, I'm going to be using the Santorini shade from the same palette, and I'm just going to pop that on my cheeks and blend that. So again, with my Morphe 35P, I'm going to run that shade here under my eyes. And then I want to take this shade here. And then with the exact same brush, I'm going to take a darker shade here. Take this shade here. And I'm just going to run it above where my cut crease is. I'm going to be using another MAC lipstick though, in the shade Spirit. Yes. So this is my favorite. As you can see, it's a bit... This is what I hate about like... these lipsticks, like, because they're kind of creamier, like, when instead of getting the matte ones, like, this is like the creamy ones. Look at that. There you go. So if you can see, like, it has a tendency to break, and then like, so you have to have it sitting right inside the like container, and then that like knocks against like the rim, and then I just don't like that it's so flimsy, but it's still a really good lipstick. So it just scares me because it likes to wiggle around a lot in the container, and then it just pushes against it, and then it's just fucking... it's really pretty, like, it's a really pretty color. I have nothing against, like, really pretty color, like, it's really pigmented. It's just that's the one thing I hate, is that it just wiggles a little bit too much around. It's not that I'm being forceful with my application, like, I'm doing it so gently. It's literally just going and just like hitting all the sides, and then it just gets like all these bumps and stuff, and then it just like has a tendency to break, and that's what I hate. I might just add the Nikki in the middle. Okay guys, so that's the end of my video. I hope you guys really liked it. Please like, share, comment, subscribe, just do fucking whatever. I don't really, just do what you need to do, all right? I'd just like to thank like all of you guys for watching. It means so much to me. Like, I know that obviously it tells me like, you know, the views, blah, 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 but it's just really nice when I, like on the weekend I went out and there was a few people that came up to me and said, oh, like I enjoy your videos, or like, you know, I watch your videos on. Like, it just means so much to me that people like actually watch, like, you know, that like real people actually watch my videos. Like, it's just so nice that, you know, I'm getting that really positive feedback. Like, it's taken me a lot of guts to do this, and it's so rewarding when people say that they like enjoy my videos. Like, do you know what I mean? I do this for you guys. Like, I don't, like, I love playing with makeup. Like, I just want to show you guys like what I can do and what you can potentially do too. Like, I don't know, like, I'm just really happy. But anyway, thanks guys. Please let me know what you think about this video. Comment any other videos that you want me to do. You can follow me on Instagram as well as on Snapchat. I was gonna say Twitter, I don't know, fucking Twitter. Alright, you can follow me on Instagram and Snapchat, and so that's at Melanie Pepito. As well, I am really sorry about the lighting, like I said before. So, like, I love you guys so much. I love the fact that, you know, I'm doing this. It means a lot that people are actually enjoying my videos, I guess. Yeah, so that's enough of me rambling on. So I'll see you guys next time, okay? Bye!